teacher interview about 9/11,
sour candy egg challenge,
no fighting skit,
and much more on this week's Roadrunner Report.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. Right hand over your heart, ready, begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. You may be seated.
Good morning, Roadrunners. It's Friday, September 11th.
Our reporter Grace interviewed Mr. Gouveia, a 7th grade social studies teacher.
Let's hear what he had to say about 9/11.
Before we start, can we please have a moment of silence for the people who passed away on 9/11?
My name is Grace, and I'll be interviewing Mr. Gouveia, a 7th grade social studies teacher. Hi, how are you?
Pretty good.
All right. How do you feel about 9/11?
9/11 was a very big moment in American history. It's one of these events that has changed life in America forever. One of those events you'll never forget.
Okay. Did it impact your life at all?
It impacted everybody's life in America. For better or for worse, it's changed American society.
Do you remember where you were when 9/11 happened?
Yeah, everybody in their life will have one of those events that you will never forget where you were, what was going on, the surroundings. An example, my parents, it would be the assassination of John F. Kennedy was one of those events that they can tell you exactly where they were. 9/11, for myself, was one of those events. I was actually getting ready to go to class. I was in college at the time. I woke up in the morning, I was eating breakfast, watching the news, and I saw what was unfolding in New York, and it was a pretty scary time. I remember everything. I still went to school that day, and I remember my professor, it was a history class, told us to go home and watch the news and see what was going on, because history is unfolding as we speak.
Okay. Was it an emotional time for you?
Definitely. Nobody knew what was going on. Everybody was scared. It was one of those events that people just hunkered down, they watched the news. And we're hoping that bad things weren't happening, or anything worse wasn't going on around in the country. Just the unknown, it was pretty scary.
How does 9/11 affect Prescott students today?
9/11 affects everybody up until this time, because it is one of those events that everyone should know about. We never want a situation like that to repeat itself again, and one of the biggest reasons that you guys are studying history in middle school and in high school is so that you learn from the past and you learn how to right the wrongs of the past. And so hopefully by students learning what happened at 9/11, understanding the history of it, hopefully something like that will never happen again.
Okay. Is there anything else you'd like to add?
It was a pretty sad time in American history. And again, I hope it never happens again.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
We'll be right back. What do annoying peppers do?
Oh no, what do they do?
They get jalapeno business.
That's so funny.
Whoa, that looks interesting.
What are you talking about? What looks interesting?
The poster that caught my attention.
Oh, you mean the town show poster?
Yeah, I haven't been in one until now. I guess I'm gonna join.
I'll join with you.
What do we have to lose?
Our dignity?
Oh, come on, it'll be fun.
Okay, all right. But we're gonna have to practice because the show's tomorrow.
I.
Sorry, can't make it. Something came up at school and I can't make
it. Oh, so that is why someone picked you up early.
What are we gonna do now? We have nothing to practice!
Whoa, take a chill pill. We'll figure something out.
What are we gonna find? The show is first thing after school!
We'll practice outside. Is dodgeball okay?
Yeah, are you sure you're gonna be there?
I'm pretty sure.
I brought the balls for practice.
So what are we gonna do now?
Well, I had an idea about throwing them, but dodging them.
Okay, seems legit. Let's practice.
Okay.
I'm nervous, Donovan. Aren't you?
I am a little bit, but I can deal with it.
Ladies and gentlemen, we now have the group that is going to show its talent in dodgeball. They got an almost perfect score of 20. The dodgeball group gets the first place trophy.
After the talent show, the dodgeball competitors realized that they had incredible talents.
Recently at school, there have been fights at Sunny's and on campus.
The principal and Roadrunner staffs are trying to prevent fighting at school or at Sunny's.
Our Roadrunners, Jacob, Ray, and Araceli, filmed a skit to remind you that there's no fighting allowed at school or Sunny's.
Dude, look at this Barbie I got for my birthday!
Dude, it's really cool, I'm gonna take it!
Hey, give it back!
No!
Take it out! Take it out!
No fighting at school!
Ooh, candy!
Grace, Josh, and Mario did a candy egg challenge and it got messy.
Let's see how messy it got and who won.
The challenge that we're going to be doing is there's 5 mystery candies underneath all this whipped cream and we have to find them and eat them without using our hands. Go!
I think I got them all.
I got all mine.
Got all mine.
Ham. I can't swallow these.
Done.
No, you're not.
Ah.
Done.
Okay, hang on.
Done.
Done!
The winner is Josh Richardson.
What color is your nail?
Why such a random question?
We had some roadrunners go out and ask random questions.
What is your favorite cereal?
Lucky Charms.
Excuse me, what's your favorite movie?
My favorite movie is Despicable Me 2.
Hunger Games.
The same, Hunger Games.
Excuse me, do you mind if we ask you a question?
Yeah.
How old are you?
I'm 12.
12.
12.
Thanks for having us.
What is your favorite type of shoe?
I like Crocs.
What high school are you going to after Prescott?
Enox.
What is your favorite TV show?
I don't have one.
What's your favorite cartoon?
My favorite cartoon is One Piece.
Thank you.
What is your favorite basketball team?
The Cavs.
Warriors.
That's our show for the week.
Thanks for watching.
Please remember the lives we lost on this day in history.
Before we start, can we please have a moment of silence for the people?
What's up?
Sorry. Recorder? Oh, sorry.